Here we are at Shop of the Cop 2011 edition. My uniform's kind of changed since the last go around because I retired. I'm here with Mayor elect Dennis Tyler.
Hi.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Chuck. Glad
it's
to be here.
It's been a long time coming, man.
Yeah.
we appreciate you. Glad to be here
with Shop with a Cop.
And you've done this, I don't know, probably 10 or 15 years. You've done it about every year since we've been here. Plus, he shows up at the summer events as well.
Yes.
So it's been real nice to have you around, and I'm so glad you won the election.
Well, I appreciate it. You guys do a great job for our kids in the Christmas time and actually all year round. So it's great to be here again today.
Yeah, we're glad to have you as a part of this.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
You're welcome.
Have a great day.
You too. I'm here with political royalty. we did the mayor, now we're moving on. Starting over here is Brad Polk, Doug Marshall, and Nora Powell. Brad's been there a while, and these two have just joined the crew. You excited, guys?
I am.
Yeah,
I know you two are. You've got to be very excited.
Yes, we are.
Brad, you're the lone guy, I think, are you?
There's one other.
One other. I wasn't sure.
We're going to work together.
We're going to work together.
Absolutely.
That's good. I've known Brad for as long as I can remember.
Yeah.
Well, we worked at Westminster Village together years and years ago.
Yeah.
But I'm talking about, we're talking about probably 15, 20 years ago.
I worked with his brothers.
Did you?
Yeah.
Family
Sheriff's Department. Yeah.
It's a small world.
There's a bunch
everybody
of them.
Everybody knows everybody.
That's right. That's my
name.
Everybody knows
everybody
else.
Yeah.
And you guys, this is your first time around?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Well, yeah. I've helped out in the past with Dad.
I thought you had, but I wasn't sure.
No, I haven't helped before with Shop for Cop, but we've done the
Toys for Tots.
Toys for Tots.
You're in everything, too, I know.
And the Santa on Christmas Eve, and so this was the
Well, we appreciate you coming out to this.
Most definitely.
It's pretty large this year. This is our second biggest one. The newspaper articles and WTHR helped us quite a bit.
Yeah.
So, and then a lot of businesses jumped in, and we're really glad that everybody got on board. So.
You do a good job.
Thanks, man.
We do
appreciate it. And even in your retirement.
Yes, this is my
semi-retirement. You're busier now.
Well, thanks, guys, and Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas to you, too.
And come here, Chelsea. I quit. I don't bite anymore. This is Chelsea Main. And she's with one of the organizations at Ball State, and I'll let her explain that to you.
Yeah, we're part of Alpha Phi Sigma. It's kind of referred to the Organization for Criminal Justice Students at Ball State University. We go down, we volunteer in help that we can do around the community. Anything that we can do to help broaden criminal justice experiences and learning, anything that we possibly can about the criminal justice field helps in any way.
And it looks like you're also getting involved in the community.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I want you to get that in there.
Yeah.
She's also been to our Halloween program and our food basket program. So they're a good group, and they're helping us out a lot, and we're glad Ball State's involved. Thank you, Chelsea. What painful, huh? This is Mary Jo Barton. She's been on the city council for, I don't know, as long as I can remember.
16 years.
16 years. So
since the earth cooled off.
Since the earth cooled off.
Yeah.
Now, have you been to these before?
This is my very first time.
I could have sworn I saw you at one before. I wasn't sure.
No, this is my very first time I considered it, but then something would always come out. Okay. Something with my family. So.
Well, we're glad to have you here.
Well, I'm tipped to be here. It looks like it's going to be fun.
It is fun. And we're doing 101 kids. It's the second most we've ever done.
So that's great.
We did 107 one other year, but this is a load of kids. So we'll put you with one, and we'll give you an ROTC kid, and that way you can keep track of them.
Sounds good to me.
And that's what we do.
I'm anxious.
Well, I'm glad you're
anxious to start.
To my left is a familiar face, if you follow our programs. This is Kathy Perkins. She's with Crime Stoppers and Pilot Club.
And Pilot Club.
And does both, and she's always at these events.
Yeah, I enjoy coming to these events we have all the time.
Right. And you love the kids, I know.
Oh, yeah.
I see you shopping.
We've got a really good crowd this time.
Yes, we do. It's getting packed back there.
So
we'll try to get rolling here real soon. Well, thanks, guys, ladies.
Well, thank
you.
My
pleasure.
You.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
An integral part of every one of our programs has been the ROTC programs at both Central and Southside. And gosh, without them, this would not fly, because they are definitely the glue that holds this thing together. They shop with the cops, with the kids, and make sure that everything stays in line monetary-wise, and they keep track of stuff. This young man's from Central.
Yeah, I'm Major Tim Cummins, Muncie Central JROTC program.
How long have you been there, Tim?
Since April this year. I replaced Major Flynn.
That's what I remember was Major Flynn, and it's been a while. How many kids do you have here?
We've got about 15 right now, but we're expecting 22.
Good, that's good. Your kids do a lot of events.
Yeah. This is the culminating event for our fall semester. And we're happy to be here.
We're glad to have you.
Yeah,
gotcha. Right over here.
I'm Master Sergeant Bob Harbour, Marine instructor from Southside High School. This is one of our favorite events every year. The kids really look forward to helping Santa out for these kids in our community. And, you know, one of the things we preach is giving back to our community.
Right. So, how many years have you been doing this? It's been a
this
while.
This is my ninth.
I knew it. He's been around a while.
each one's more enjoyable. You do a great job in the police department. You know, it's great that you guys.
Well, we appreciate you guys showing up and bringing all these kids with you.
Thanks for the opportunity.
Major Rick? Good to have you again,
Chuck.
We did an event last night together for the food basket.
For food basket, yes, we did out at Myers.
Yeah.
And now here we're with the kids this morning, and we're excited.
And I'm telling you, this guy is our right hand of this event, because him and his organization and his people, they pick out 90% of the kids that are here, and they do a great job of income qualifying them and getting the community that needs this sort of help out here. And we appreciate it.
Well, I tell you, you know, it's not about the police department. We appreciate the Muncie Police Department, the Crime Stoppers, the Fire Department, everybody that comes out. It's not about the Salvation Army. It's about helping the kids that need it in our community. And I've been, you know, this is my last go-around because
right.
I retire.
How about that? Yeah.
But we'll be back. We'll be back to stand on the other side and help out. But, you know, this has been such an important event for our community.
Right.
I can't tell you how proud I am to be working with you and doing it properly so that these kids don't get left out.
I agree. I appreciate everything you do. This guy here on the right, I won't call him any names. I promised my wife I wouldn't give him any status. This is Bart Mills from Selma. Bart's been around with us for, gosh, since we began this thing. I'm not even sure how many years we have now. 15, 20, somewhere.
Somewhere around there.
And every time Bart's here, I mean, I can't recall a time he's missed. He has a lot of shopping that he gets done with the kids, and he'll go two and three times, whatever it takes to get through the entire crowd. So, Bart, another year.
Yes, sir.
When you going to retire?
I have no idea. I'm like you.
Well, when you do, come see me.
I'm like you. It's hard to put an old dinosaur down on this stuff.
That's true. That's true. We all tend to go, go, go.
Very much so.
I see some Santa hats down there. We'll have to get those on tape later. Well, thanks, Bart.
You too, sir.
I'll see you over there on the other side.
Okay.
I know, I'm shocked.
Hey, I'm going to start right. So anyway, let all your guys down here know, and if you could, get the central, and then pass that on here. I appreciate it. The safest spot. See my briefcase down there?
All right, thank you very much.
We're ready to start. Make sure you stay at $100 or less. We can't go over. We barely have enough to do the event, barely. We have about 100 left after the event. So if you guys all go over like you did one year, I'll be $6,000 in the hole. So, and we can't afford that.
Write a check.
That's good. That thing will bounce all the way down. So be sure and stay at 100 or less. Don't worry about taxes. We're tax exempt. But be sure, like I say, be sure and stay at 100 or less. And I'm going to go on down the line and say that again so everybody can hear it.
Awesome.
Everybody hear that?
Yes, sir.
Make sure and stay at 100 or less, because I don't have enough to pay if we go over 100. Okay? Thanks for showing up, everybody, and we'll start.
Thanks for all your work.
Oh, no problem. Yes. We'll be running them probably down this way if we can. Yeah, you guys might want to take him from the far end. Brad's got a point. That's why he's a politician, I'm not.
Always solving problems.
Oh, you are. I follow these gentlemen, and I need three. There's a couple cops.
Up to the front, grab cars if you can. Thanks.
Need a couple cops to go here. You want some? I got three kids down there at the bar end, and three ROTC.
Forget about dogs.
Oh, yeah.
One, two.
Next. Three. Where are you guys from?
I've not been interviewing kids, have I?
Yeah.
Turn around here, guys. Look at the guy on the camera.
Muncie?
What school you go to? Wilson?
Southside.
You enjoy school?
Somewhat.
I was waiting to see if I got
at least she's
answer,
honest.
Right? Yeah. Well, guys, have fun. You're chopping for three, you say?
Yes.
The other one's not here?
Yeah.
Oh, Dakota, yeah. $100 a piece. Guys, three of you? Yeah, there's only two kids, but mom needs help keeping track too. Carts are down that way. Next?
You wake up.
Got two?
Yeah, I think it's just him.
Just him?
Okay. Yeah.
And what's your name?
Austin.
Austin? What school you go to? Wilson? Wow, we got a lot of months up here. Well, you have fun, man. Shop wisely.
Who's the one?
Austin?
Oh, I didn't see that. You
know what I mean? And
Grandpa.
Cool.
I don't know. I would just leave it here and go down to that and grab a car.
Come on, guys.
Yeah.
How old are you?
I'm
3.
How old are you?
How old are you? How many are you?
3.
3? Okay. She's free. Well, you have fun, huh? This young man will help you shop today.
How about that?
Just go down there and grab a cart. Next.
Now remember, you're 3.
Free. Not 3. Free. Shop for 3? These two? Okay.
Yeah.
And you guys are from what school?
Central.
First. Did you go to Northside?
Yeah.
Was I there when you were there? Okay.
Grab a couple people here. Yeah. Okay.
That's what I meant.
Okay.
And then grab 2 of the other kids.
How are you?
Heather.
Hi, Heather.
You're welcome.
My name's
Hi. Hey, Gary. How are you, bud?
2 ROTC kids are there.
Thank you.
Either off the top of my head. But we got some guys to help you here. I need 3 for this group. You want to come, Mary Jo? Stephanie? Help with this group? And then we got, that's 3. These officers here will help you. This lady's a city councilwoman. And we've got 3 ROTC kids here to help too, and they'll keep track of the money for you.
I'm glad
right.
Stephanie's in uniform because
she
looks
is.
Like a kid.
Got her uniform on.
I'd mistake her for a kid.
She weighs as much as my leg. How's it going? How many are you shopping for?
Just this one.
Okay.
Yeah.
You ready?
Sure.
You
what
money?
Am I supposed to do?
Did you Salvation Army?
There you go. Okay. I'm sorry.
All right, 1.
Care.
This is Doug Marshall, he's the city councilman.
Hi,
just one guy, just one. 1 ROTC. And just make sure
you
keep the money right. Hey, how are you?
Like he's
hot, too. Recognize that face. You got 3?
3.
All right. You love this? I like
yeah.
It. Now, which reindeer are you?
She's Rudolph.
She's Rudolph. Okay, I was going
to
ask
we're still trying to figure out who we are.
Okay.
This one glitzes.
And you got Santa behind you, I see.
Yes.
Well, you guys have fun, and we'll pair you up with 3 officers over here. 3? Any 3?
Thank you.
3 people?
3?
Hi. 3? This is Steve. And who's the 3rd one?
I don't
like that little kid.
I don't care.
Somebody jump in.
And this young lady here will help you too. And then we got 3 ROTC kids that will go with you to keep track of everything.
So we got, is this 300 here?
Yeah, 100 per kid, and just make sure you don't spend over, okay? We love it that way. This is Officer Howell, by the way. And I don't know who you are.
I'm Chelsea.
Chelsea.
Taylor.
Taylor. County?
I got volunteered into this. I'm his girlfriend.
Oh, okay, okay.
They said, we're short-handed, so I'm volunteering your girlfriend. I was like,
all right, that works for us. We appreciate that. Hey, guys. Hello. How many? Just one? You ready for Christmas? Or are you getting ready for Christmas? Just one. Who wants to be a single?
Hi, Lily. Who we got?
This is Lieutenant Bench. She's from Muncie Police Department. Yeah, that's fine. And that young man will help you too, and he's from Southside ROTC, and he'll help keep you track money wise, okay?
Go ahead, Nora.
Okay.
This is Nora.
Hi.
She's the city councilwoman.
Nora Roberts.
Oh, that's what I meant. Roberts is an author. I just
and she doesn't need an ROTC kid for this one. So
this is Eric. Nice to meet you, Eric.
I'm going to be at the snack bar.
Just we'll grab an officer, and I wish I had more money.
So.
You want to go?
Sure, absolutely.
It's just one, actually.
All right.
So
that's fine.
Take her and grab that young man. And
let's go spend some money. One night.
My good man idea. Here will help you too.
Okay. I'm Larry. Michael Sheldon. My friend. Let's go spend Chuck's money. Right. Sound good?
The carts are
down. Carts are down.
Yeah.
All right.
Yep.
Hi.
Hello.
Oh, I need some of my punch on.
Very young.
How old are you? Congratulations. You have fun getting some Christmas stuff. Take one of these guys with you so you can kind of keep track of it.
Okay.
And then one officer. Who wants to go? This one? All right.
Okay.
Nick? This one's one of my kids. This one's north side. Shorty's what
oh,
we call
man.
It. Good to see you, man. Just one? Okay. Just one guy. Who wants to go?
I'll go.
All right. One ROTC.
All right.
One? Okay. What school you go to? Southside. All right. Need one. One? One?
He has a nickname, but I won't tell you one.
I'll tell all your nicknames.
There we go. Uh-oh. There we go with that. See you guys. This is Officer Mitch. A long line of Officer Mitch.
Who are you? Sydney? Nice to meet you, Sydney. Hi. Are you Mom? Hi, Mom.
You might want to just park your cart there and then go down the end and grab it. It's real hard to get your carts there. Thanks, guys. Next? How many you got?
Three.
Wow. You got them at stair step.
You got two
more at home. Wow. You go to Wilson? You know Officer Clevenger? He's out here somewhere shopping. We'll meet you with three officers and three ROTCs so they can keep track of the money.
You got two right here.
All right. There's two. One more? One more.
One more.
Big deal.
Hey.
You will take three of the ROTCs. That's funny. And then grab an ROTC kid there.
What's your name?
Have fun now.
No.
One. This is Sergeant Jay.
How are you?
Jack?
Jack?
That is my dad's cousins.
Oh, wow.
I'm Harry's.
Look at that here. He's one ROTC kid. And they'll have to make that.
Hi. Hi, Chuck.
You snuck up on me. There. Just one?
Two.
Okay. Got two more here. And this one went to Northside.
So
that one, I don't, you must have never got in trouble. Unlike your mother. Unlike your mother. So I need two guys. The Qualls's?
Sure. The Qualls boys are back.
Playing. Big Q and little Q.
Big Q and little Q.
two ROTCs. Ready?
Ready?
All right. Hey, what's up? I didn't know you were in ROTC.
I think
it's
probably in, but that's just something to make sure. Whoa. Is that good enough? Do you still want me to look and see if there's any more? Okay. Anything else? Just look on Wednesday. Rest out.
That's okay. That's okay. Trying to find girl stuff.
think I'd be used to. It was three girls in my house, but I'm not, no good today.
So how's it going, Desi?
Pretty good, Roger. How about yourself?
All right.
Getting to introduce you. This is Sean Cooper and his daughter, Nisha Cooper. They are from Wilson. She is from Wilson Middle School. She just got in having a major surgery and wanted to get her involved out here at the Shop with the Cop program. And she's having a lot of fun. Got a lot of clothes for her.
Great. Great. You having fun? Good. How's it going?
Doing good, sir. How are you?
All right.
I got two young ladies walking away from us. One knows what she wants, the other one she doesn't. Doesn't know what she wants. This is my faithful Ball State assistant.
Jack.
Jay?
Yep. How's it going?
I think this might be Jay's first time out here, so.
Yeah, it's the first one.
Teach him all the ropes, all the tricks of the trade.
Yeah, better learn the ropes.
We must thank our sponsors because this event was going to be about 50 kids in the beginning if we were lucky. And I'll tell you right now, there are two sponsors on this board that started the ball rolling. One being WTHR, Channel 13, Jeannie Redovich, and they took their cue off the Star Press. The Star Press ran some articles talking about the other group that's fundraising and how it's affected ours. And thanks to those articles, WTHR picked it up and also put the word out there. With all those people talking and all the information in the press, who stepped forward first was Muncie Mall. The manager at the Muncie Mall put up a booth. You see our little logo down there. Muncie Mall, the manager, Stacy Nance, put up a booth for us, or had us have a booth for no cost. We raised about $2,000 in the mall just by people walking up and giving us money. Part of that $2,000 came from Auntie Ann's, who's not on here. I forgot to put them on, but I got to thank them because they were a big integral part of that. Once the news articles hit, along with the Muncie Mall, Bill Gaddis and Bill McCoy both picked up, right now picked up to help us. Also on that pickup off of the articles was Easy Pawn. And there's our Easy Pawn and the check being given to us. And Texas Roadhouse. You can't hardly see my logo. I didn't do a good job on that logo. But the Texas Roadhouse had an event for us, a 10% event, where all the proceeds of the evening of people bringing in slips saying they're trying to help Shop with the Cop, 10% of their bill went toward this program. And that was a sizable amount, as you can well imagine. Family Vision Care, the employees have once a month have a day where they can wear casual clothing if they pay so much. They usually pick a charity each month, and they picked us. Millennium Productions, of course, and Roger Overby, everybody knows him. So I'm surprised he's not governor by now.
What a jerk.
And then our 3M people at Hartford City, they've helped us almost every year, a sizable contribution. And again, they came through this year. Is there anybody I'm forgetting? Oh, our main sponsor and our biggest contributor, Muncie Target. We thank them a couple of times on here. I think that's about it on this board.
Here comes trouble.
Yep. And we want to thank the people of Muncie. I got, I don't know how many checks through the mail up at City Hall. And another sponsor that's not on here because we got the check kind of late, but it was a great help. It was Wishbone Gifts in downtown Muncie. So thanks to everybody and all these organizations and all the police and firemen that showed up, the ROTCs that showed up, Ball State University's criminal justice fraternity showed up. I had more people helping than I had kids, and we had 101 this year. So that's our second biggest amount since we started this program. We did 107 one year when Eric Estrada was here. And I want to thank everybody that worked so hard on this and got our money up so that we could actually afford to do the program. And I know these kids are having a Merry Christmas this year.
Let's
see what Santa Claus was good to him this year.
Amen. Right, watch and everything.
Funny toys.
That works.
Okay. Well,
what do you got there?
Jacob.
That one's gonna bring it up.
Donnie's
over. Okay. We're getting ready to go up too. Can you say thank you? Tell the camera thank you.
Sam, thank you.
Thank you. Did you say it?
You say thank you to them, Sam?
Thank you.
What's in that, Addison? What's in that?
Toys.
Toys?
What is that, though? Is that rubber ducky?
Selma's well represented today.
Yeah, enjoying it in the Christmas spirit today.
Good. Yeah. Good. Do you have fun shopping?
Absolutely. Had two good girls, got in, got their what she needed, and we're back up here. It's a good day.
Great. This isn't your first time, is it, Steve?
No, it's several times I've done this. It's great, isn't it?
Yeah.
She wanted to know her bed size.
I texted you. I asked you
what.
I couldn't hear anything. Bed size of the twin. That's what I thought, but I wasn't sure. I texted you. I asked you.
He gets.
No, I didn't get that. I just got home.
Happy holidays to all of you. Okay.
Thank you.
We're at the end now. We did 101 kids total, and we had, I don't know how many cops, more than we had kids. It was an amazing turnout, and a couple of the attendees, Captain Mark Vollmar, Sergeant Steve Stewart. These guys have they're coming up through the ranks. They're trading those insignias in for Chief Stars, so Congratulations.
Thank you, Chuck. I appreciate that. I really do. Appreciate
Thank
that.
Thank you.
And I know you guys worked hard because, heck, I was with you up there the whole time. And Mark actually was an intern with me for a while.
A long time ago.
That was a long time ago.
Steve was a reserve. I think you got on reserves, too, didn't you?
Same time.
Yep, same time.
So they came up through the ranks, got on regulars, made their careers and their lives, and now they're up the top. They're there.
Well, so, January 1st.
January 1st, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
And I appreciate you guys coming to shop with a cop, and I assume you're going to keep having these cops come out here.
Yes. Well, I want to thank you, Chuck. It's a great event. It seems to get better and better every year. And, you know, this time of year, that's what we want to do is give back. So.
Right.
And for me today, it was great to see the mom cry.
Yeah.
You know, it really
You had
it
a
was.
Mom cry on you?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, that's
so,
sweet.
You know, that's what it's all about.
Now, what did you shop with, boys or girls?
I had three girls.
Those are tough to shop for.
Yes. And it, we hit the makeup aisle. We hit the jewelry aisle. And we hit the book aisle, as a matter of fact.
Oh, that's good.
So her favorite subject is English.
English?
She loves to read. So I definitely encouraged her with that.
Well, that's good.
That's good, yeah.
And what'd you have, Mark?
I helped a 15-year-old girl get her Christmas shopping done. So
oh,
it was
wow.
kind of fun.
It is a great event. And you can't help but start the season with a good feeling when you do
right.
this. So. Well, I appreciate both of you.
Chuck, thank you.
Congratulations
thank you.
Again.
Thank you.
Good
thank
program,
you.
Chuck.
All righty.
Very good.
Thanks, guys.
All right.
I'm here with Jesse Skinner and his son. What's your son's name?
Cole.
Cole. All right. Did you help your dad shop today?
Yeah.
And who did you guys shop for? Boy, girl?
Two girls, Destiny and Daisha Cooper. They are from Wilson Middle School. And Daisha just had major surgery.
Oh, man.
And she's trying to recover. And the family's having a hard time, so it's something that we
really
get
believed in.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And Jesse believes in our organization and the cause so much that that little sign of the booth back there at the mall, he manned, I don't know how many hours, a ton. He was our big guy on the fundraising end. People like his face. I don't know why. I haven't figured that one out yet.
But yeah, me either. It was just one of those things.
But he got the most contributions of everybody out there, and what we really needed, and we appreciate it.
It's something that, I like doing.
Oh,
anything for the kids.
And he contacted me about this thing, and I didn't contact him, and that's how it began. I mean, just volunteering, just getting involved. Thanks, Jess.
No problem. Thank you.
Colt, you going to be a cop when you grow up? Got to start, don't you? See you guys. How we doing, guys?
Great.
These guys have been here forever, to almost every event we've had. Bruce is the dad, Brandon's the son, and as you can see, they're both cops.
Big Q and Little Q.
Big Q with the sergeant's badge and Little Q with the patrolman's badge.
That's right.
We've been around quite a while, and I'm glad you guys came out again. How many kids did you shop for?
We each did one, so two.
Yeah. Boys, girls?
We enjoy it.
Two girls.
Teenage girls.
Teenage girls.
But that was tough.
Not really.
It wasn't as bad as I had anticipated, because I know how teenage girls can be very particular on their shopping and everything.
Oh, yeah.
But it went much smoother and much faster than what I thought.
Well,
but we had a good time. They both thanked us, and their mother did, when we got finished with checking out, and that made it all worthwhile.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, their faces lit up and said thank you and wish us a Merry Christmas, and I'm going, that's why we do it.
That's right. Well, absolutely. We appreciate you greatly.
We enjoy doing it.
Absolutely.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank
all
you
right.
for having us.
See you all next year.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Thank you.
The Salvation Army is an integral part of this whole program, and we've talked to Major Rick, and he's retiring, but you're not, are you?
I don't plan on going anytime soon. I plan on staying.
This is Christina Paul, and I'll let you introduce everybody else.
This is Christopher Maddy and Becky Norris.
And they're with the Salvation Army.
Uh-huh.
Now, Becky used to be in charge of this program.
Yep, I took over.
And then you just come in on your own time.
She still gets a lot of my time.
Good. I'm glad you guys stayed involved.
Can't do it without her. So.
And then we're almost at the end, I think, finally.
Yes.
And we'll go up and settle up the bill, and then I'll get with you, and we had some families not show, and we'll go ahead and get the money to the Salvation Army to get out to them. So that'll work. Thank you much.
Thank you. Thanks, sir.
Thank you.
Here with Allison Quirk and City Council again,
yes,
as always. And
very excited.
She rarely misses an event like this.
Right.
So she's helped us out for multiple years. Even when you had your baby, I remember you bringing the little baby out.
Yeah.
So you've been a great supporter, and we loved having you here.
Well, I think this is a great event for the community, and we're very thankful that you guys take the time to do this to give back to the families. So.
Good.
It's a great event to participate in and to see the kids go and get their things off their list.
Right. So. And we agree. We love having you guys and the cops and everybody else. And if there's anybody out there that knows of a hypoallergenic Christmas tree, she wants it.
I need one. I do. I need one.
Well, thank you.
Well, thank you very much. Alrighty. Thank you for organizing this. We appreciate it.
You too. This is Officer Laux. He's with our department. I think, are you on the county too?
I'm on the county as well.
He volunteers both. I mean, he's a switch hitter. Yeah, he's a switch hitter. But he switch hits all for free. So, I mean, he helps out the community. He helps out this program. I noticed you've directed traffic before for Target and everything else. So,
yeah, it's great. The last 27 years, I'm always doing something, but I love doing this.
You do. And then if I need help during the event, I mean, from the very time I walk in the door, Kim's with me and helping me and getting people here and calling people over and carrying the calculators and just a multitude of things. He always does help. He's our helper and just constant, and he's always here. Yeah. And we appreciate you every time.
Well, we appreciate it too, and I know the community does as well. So,
did you shop with a girl or boy this time?
I had one of each.
One of each?
A sister and a brother.
Oh, that's
the
cool.
The brother was done in about 5 minutes and the girl was done in about 25 minutes. So. But it always works out well.
The boy knew what he wanted.
Exactly.
And one for manhood. Thanks, Kim.
Hey, you're very welcome, sir. Thank you very much.
Familiar face, David Garrett.
Hello,
Muncie
how are
Target.
You doing all right today?
Good. Well, thanks to you and the event and your corporate sponsorship and all the work you do. David does a ton of behind-the-scenes work preparing for this that you can't believe. Just everything from the fundraising all the way through to the logistics to the people. He just does it all. So, and Target's been our sponsor for, I don't remember how many years, but several.
Yes.
And today turned out really good.
It was a great time.
Had more cops than we did kids this time for the first time since Eric Estrada left.
Mm-hmm.
And it was really nice having that kind of turnout. And,
yeah, it was a great time.
And you had management people here. You had all kinds of help with the employees, and we appreciated that greatly.
Yeah, and all the employees really enjoyed the time back in electronics and toys with the kids. So right. It was a good time for everybody.
It was. Thanks, David.
No problem. Thank you.
You're welcome.